changes. When atomic fire consumed the Earth, those who survived did so in great underground vaults. When they opened, their inhabitants set out across the ruins of the old world to build new societies, establishing villages, forming tribes. As decades passed, what had been the American Southwest united beneath the flag of the new California Republic, dedicated to old world values of democracy and the rule of law. As the Republic grew, so did its needs. Scouts spread east, seeking territory and wealth in the dry and merciless expanse of the Mojave Desert. They returned with tales of a city untouched by the warheads that had scorched the rest of the world, and a great wall spanning the Colorado River. The NCR mobilized its army and sent it east to occupy Hoover Dam and restore it to working condition. But across the Colorado, another society had arisen under a different flag. A vast army of slaves forged from the conquest of 86 tribes, Caesar's Legion. 4 years have passed since the Republic held the dam, just barely, against the Legion's onslaught. The Legion did not retreat. Across the river, it gathers strength. Campfires burn. Training drums beat. Through it all, the New Vegas Strip has stayed open for business under the control of its mysterious overseer, Mr. House, and his army of rehabilitated tribals and police robots. You are a courier hired by the Mojave Express to deliver a package to the New Vegas Strip. What seemed like a simple delivery job has taken a turn for the worse.
You got what you were after, so pay up.
You're crying in the rain, Pally.
Guess who's waking up over here?
Time to cash out.
Will you get it over with?
Maybe cons kill people without looking them in the face. But I ain't a fink. Dig. You've made your last delivery, kid. Sorry you got twisted up in this scene. From where you're kneeling, must seem like an 18-carat run of bad luck. Truth is, the game was rigged from the start.
You're awake. How about that? Whoa, easy there, easy. You've been out cold a couple of days now. Why don't you just relax a second? Get your bearings. Let's see what the damage is. How about your name? Can you tell me your name? I can't say it's what I'd have picked for you, but if that's your name, that's your name. I'm Doc Mitchell. Welcome to Good Springs. Now, I hope you don't mind, but I had to go rooting around there in your noggin to pull all the bits of lead out. I take pride in my needlework, but you'd better tell me if I left anything out of place. How'd I do? Well, I got most of it right anyway. Stuff that mattered. Okay. No sense keeping you in bed anymore. Let's see if we can get you on your feet. Good. Why don't you walk down to the end of the room? Over by that vigor tester machine there. Take it slow now. It ain't a race. Ooh, looking good so far. Go ahead and give the vigor tester a try. We'll learn right quick if you get back all your faculties. Good to see them bullets didn't affect your charm none. Well, we know your vitals are good. But that don't mean them bullets didn't leave you nutter than a bighorn drop. What do you say you take a seat in my couch and we go through a couple of questions? See if your dogs are still barking. All right. I'm gonna say a word. I want you to say the first thing that comes to mind. Dog. House. Night. Bandit. Light. Mother. Okay, now I got a few statements. I want you to tell me how much they sound like something you'd say. First one, conflict just ain't in my nature. I ain't given to relying on others for support. I'm always fixin' to be the center of attention. I'm slow to embrace new ideas. I charge in to deal with my problems head on. Almost done here. What do you say you have a look at this? Tell me what you see. Okay, how about this one? Last one. Well, that's all she wrote. I don't have nothing to compare it to, so maybe you'd better just have a look at the results. See if it all seems right to you. Thank you. Before I turn you loose, I need one more thing from you. I got a form for you to fill out so I can get a sense of your medical history. Just a formality. Ain't like I expect to find you got a family history of getting shot in the head. I guess that about does it. Come with me. I'll see you out. Here, these are yours. It was all you had on you when you was brought in. I hope you don't mind, but I gave the note a look. I thought it might help me find a next of kin. But it was just something about a platinum chip. Well, if you're heading back out there, you ought to have this. They call it a Pip-Boy. I grew up in one of them vaults they made before the war. We all got one. Ain't much use to me now, but you might want such a thing after what you've been through. I know what it's like having something taken from you. And put this on, too, so the locals don't pick on you for lacking modesty. It was my wife's. I think she was about your size, and she hardly wore it after we left the vault. Felt it was too brazen. Don't mention it. It's what I'm here for. You should talk to Sunny Smiles before you leave town. She can help you learn to fend for yourself in the desert. She'll likely be at the saloon. I reckon some of the other folks at the saloon might be able to help you out, too. And the metal fella, Victor, who pulled you out of your grave. Anyway, you ever get hurt out there, you come right back. I'll fix you up. But try not to get killed anymore.
Howdy, partner.
Might I say you're looking fit as a fiddle?
Don't mention it. I'm always ready to lend a helping hand to a stranger in need. I was out for a stroll that night when I heard the commotion up the old bone orchard. Saw what looked like a bunch of bad eggs, so I laid low. Once they had run off, I dug you up to see if you were still kicking. Turns out you were, so I hauled you off to the dock right quick. Can't say that I'm familiar with the rascals. Some of the fine folks in town might be able to help you out with that. I moseyed into town, 10, 15 years ago. Before that, I can't quite seem to recall. Odd. Anyway, it's a right peaceful town, and I reckon it's as fine a place to settle as any. I'm a Securitron. Robco Security Model 2060B. If you ever see any of my brothers, tell them Victor says howdy. Happy?
play it again, my Johnny. Maybe you're cold, but you're so warm inside. I was always a fool.
You must be the one Doc Mitchell was patching up. The way I heard it, I didn't think you'd be walking.
For the one they call Johnny Guitar. Play it again, Johnny Guitar. What if you
out of that office? I've got plenty of supplies for sale. Even got some weapon mods and special ammo. Well worth the caps, if you ask me. If you're hurting for caps, I've also got boxes of surplus ammo in the miscellaneous section. They're not great, but you get what you pay for. Weapon mods are things like silencers, scopes, bigger magazines. Special ammo includes things like armor-piercing bullets, which don't hurt the target as much, but let you punch through armor easier. There's also hollow-point bullets, which have the opposite effect. You can kill unarmored targets easier, but they don't do shit against armor. The leader was a New Vegas type. Typical city boy. He had a bunch of great cons with him, probably hired guns. The Great Khans normally stay in their own territory way up northwest on account of them being enemies with the NCR. It's all about quantity over quality. Trouble is, you'll be cleaning and fixing your gun a lot more than usual when you use those kind of bullets. Twice. Both times I drank a lot of liquor and lost most of my caps at the card tables. In that order, now that I think about it. If you ever get to New Vegas, be sure to visit Gamora. It's the best casino in the city. You won't regret it. Word of advice, behave. Between the NCR military police and Mr. House's robots, you don't want to be causing trouble on the Strip. I'm afraid I don't know much myself. Mr. House has got his own casino, Lucky 38, but nobody goes in or out except his robots. The other casinos follow Mr. House's rules, so I guess that makes him the leader of New Vegas. As far as I know, nobody's ever laid eyes on the guy. I think that robot who pulled you out of the dirt belongs to Mr. House. If Mr. House is looking after you, it's got to be a good thing, right? You know what I'm talking about. They're tough sons of bitches. Mean, but not crazy. They'll leave you alone unless you got something they want. The Great Khans deal in illegal chems. There's a good chance that most chems you come across were made by Great Khans. Can do. Thanks. Love's like dough that's been spent. Now there's no use of crying. Tell me, where can I go? East or west or north or due south? You let the blues move in, now I'm moving out. I'm digging it.
Howdy. What can Easy Pete do for you? The one in the fancy suit seemed to be calling the shots. That's as much as I know. Other folks in town might know more. Word of advice, though, if you ever catch up with him, watch out. The man's got cold eyes like a snake, Can't be trusted, I'd say.
On the green, I don't know where it went, but it sure went flying. Love's like dough that's been spent. Now there's no use crying.
Was a prospector until I decided to settle here to get away from the NCR. Now we'll just take it easy and help out with the Brahmin and the Bighorner. Nah. Means I poke through old buildings looking for working tech and such. Some folks just call it salvaging, but never like the term. Way I see it, salvage means it's broken, near worthless. Me, I look for the good stuff. Guns, chems, spare parts. Good money in it. Nope. Had a pretty good claim once, way out east by the river, but got run off by raiders. Eventually got too old to keep going out. Don't get me wrong. The NCR's got a lot of decent folk in it. It's just that they make you part of them whether you like it or not. Towns like Good Springs and Prim don't stay independent for long. Not if you've got something the NCR wants. Still, the NCR keeps the Legion away. They're slavers, led by a guy named Caesar, or Kaisar. Not sure how you're supposed to say it. A couple of years ago, they tried to take over Hoover Dam, but the NCR beat them back. The NCR didn't or couldn't finish the job, though. The Legion's got its strength back and is getting ready for another round at the dam. My money's still on the NCR winning, but you never know. We've been hearing stories about legionaries on the Nevada side of the river, so keep a gun handy. You don't want to get caught by them. The dam powers a lot of New Vegas, and then there's all that clean water lying in Lake Mead, too. Anybody who owns the dam owns the territory. Meet and hide, mostly. Can't put a pack on them. You just lay down until you take it off. Can find a bunch of wild ones high up in the hills, but gotta be careful around them. They can put up a decent fight if cornered. The machine? Harmless, no matter what Trudy says. She thinks it's hiding something, but I think it's just a broken-down relic with no place to be. Keep your gun handy if you go poking around some of the abandoned places around here, like the schoolhouse. Critters move in there sometimes.
Cheyenne, stay. Don't worry, she won't bite unless I tell her to. Yeah, I guess there's a thing or two I could show you. Sounds like you need all the help you can get after what they done to you. Meet me outside, behind the saloon. Now, see the sarsaparilla bottles on the fence there? Take this and try to hit a couple of them. That's the right idea. Look down the sight. Try crouching down and staying still. It'll help your aim. Nice shot. Well, that's a start, but I don't reckon you came to me to learn to fight sarsaparilla bottles. Tell you what, I gotta go chase geckos away from a water supply anyway. Darn critters are attracted to it. Why don't you come along? Follow me. It's just down to the southeast a short ways. Hear that up on the ridge behind me there? We got some geckos to clear out. Bunch of little monsters is what they are. Seems like Doc Mitchell treats more gecko bites than anything else. Let's see if we can get a little closer. If we move quietly, we can get the jump on them. More likely to hit something vital that way. Okay. Getting the hang of it. There's two more wells that still need clearing. You want, you can come along. It'd be worth a few caps to me. Shouldn't take more than a couple minutes, especially with two of us. Come with me. Holy moly. If you hadn't come here like you'd done, I'd be a goner for sure. I came up here to draw water, but here, you should have what I got. You look thirsty. Now that was some good work. Even got a little exciting there at the end. Here's a little spending money for the trouble. One more thing I wanted to show you. Thought I might teach you about living off the land and making useful things for yourself. Interested? All right, then. We'll need a couple ingredients to get started. Gonna want some xander root and a brock flower. Let me think now. I know I've seen brock flowers growing up at the graveyard, and I seem to remember there being xander root over by the schoolhouse. Bring those on back to me, and we'll get cooking.
I remember though I've wandered and my happiness I've found. times I'm bound to roam, my thoughts are still of Texas and of home.
Let me see what you got. Yeah, these'll do just fine. Just fine. All right, now. We're gonna be making something folks on the trail call healing powder. Go on over to that campfire now. Give it a try. Hey, that's not bad, see? All it takes to make a recipe is the right ingredients and the right know-how. Sometimes it won't be a campfire you need. Might need to do some work on your guns and ammo, maybe. Important thing to get is it's all the same idea. You just need to find the right place to set up shop. Workbench or reloading bench, whatever. Well, I hope that's enough to get you started. I'm heading back now. Hope I didn't miss anything good on the jukebox. Cheyenne would never forgive me. Hey, do me a favor. Trudy, she's the bartender up at the Prospector. Kind of the town mom. She likes to meet newcomers. She'd be cross with me if I didn't ask you to poke your head in and say hi.
Hello? Can you help me? My girl is trapped by geckos on the ridge, and I can't get to her. Please, she's going to die. Go up the path, past the broken radio tower, and go to the right. They're at the top of the trail. You will? Thank you for helping me. Please hurry.
Thank you.
Sorry I tricked you, but thanks for clearing out the geckos. Now I can get to that stash up there, after I deal with you.
Howdy. Hi there. Sticking around Good Springs for a while longer? Sure can. Take the road southeast out of town till it hits the freeway. Prim is the town with the roller coaster straight south. Can't miss it. NCR patrols do a good job of keeping the highway clear, but I'd keep your gun where you can reach it easily. You never know who you'll run into. Off the road, you'll probably start running into hostile wildlife. My advice would be to stick to the highway when you can. Not in Good Springs, no. But if you're up for a little scavenging, there's always the schoolhouse. Most of what's in there is junk, but there's this old safe that even Easy Pete wasn't able to crack with dynamite. If you want to take a shot at it, take these. If the lock's too much for you to handle, reading through the magazine might give you the edge you need.
sin to hide behind this heartache, to make believe that I found.
You'll need those to pick the lock. Be careful, though. Put too much pressure on them and they'll snap. Always happy to help someone down on their luck. I hunt geckos mostly. The meat's pretty good and I can always find a buyer for the hides. I also help keep the town clear of rat scorpions and coyotes. Not many people live in Good Springs, so wildlife is always creeping in. Sure, what do you want to know? Southeast of here is Prim. Can't miss it. Since it has the giant old roller coaster right in the middle of town, the NCR's got an outpost there. If you follow the road north, you'll eventually hit Sloan and Quarry Junction. They mine rocks or something, but I heard they got troubles lately. I wouldn't head that direction if I were you, though. Got critters up there that don't take kindly to getting shot. The new California Republic. Bunch of settlers and soldiers coming in from the west, fixing on making Nevada their own. They can be right pushy, but the roads are safer because of them, so I tend to let it go. Not that I got a choice. Well, the wildlife for one thing, rowdy locals for another. They're protecting their own. Just happens to help us. They've been holding off this other group from the east, too. Got a funny name. Call themselves Caesar's Legion. Never seen them in these parts, so I couldn't tell you much. I hear rumors, that's about it. Supposedly, they keep slaves and they got some real nasty ways of killing folks. But maybe that's just something folks in the NCR cooked up to make themselves seem more useful here. Less uninvited. Around here, mostly coyotes and geckos. The coyotes are pretty dangerous in large packs, but otherwise they're nothing to really worry about. The geckos aren't too tough, but they've got a nasty bite. I've heard about bigger, nastier versions out in the wasteland, but I've never seen them. Stick to the roads when you can, and steer clear of the hills north of Good Springs. The critters up there are big and poisonous. If you want to know anything else, just ask. Until next time.
I'm done being nice. If you don't hand Ringo over soon, I'm going to get my friends and we're burning this town to the ground. Got it?
We'll keep that in mind. Now, if you're not going to buy something, get out. Evening.
What do you want? He's some trader who decided he'd rather shoot than pay the toll for being in our territory. He's hiding somewhere in town. Would serve these idiots right if me and my guys shot the place up after we got payback on Ringo. It is now. Me and the rest of the guys busted out of the NCR prison east of here and took over. Now we're calling the shots. None of your damn business. You ought to know better than to ask a man that kind of question. Robbed some people, burned some things, killed a few guys.
It's a sin to tell a lie. Millions of hearts have been broken just because these words were spoken. I love you. Yes, I do.
Same old shit that's been going on for years. The NCR and Legion are still fighting over Hoover Dam for some reason.
So be sure.
Let me get out of town before we talk. Too many unfriendly years around.
It's a sin.
I've run with some tough gangs, but I gotta admit, they all got nothing on the Legion. I hear they stick you up on poles and it takes a while to die. I ain't saying I'm afraid of them or nothing. But I'll be staying out of their way.
You got sense enough to know.
New California Republic. Nothing new about it. Just a bunch of people with money and power pushing everyone else around.
Done
They've got troops all over the Mojave, but it's a big desert, so it's pretty easy to avoid them if you want. Never been there since the NCRs got troops all over it. Must be pretty important. Yeah.
Hey there.
So be sure it's true. Hello. When you say well, you've been causing quite a stir. Glad I finally got to meet you. Welcome to the Prospector Saloon. Looks like our little town got itself dragged into the middle of something we don't want anything to do with. About a week ago, this traitor, Ringo, comes into town. Survivor of an attack, he says. Bad men after him. Needs a place to hide. We figured he was just in shock, so we gave him a place to lie low. We didn't actually expect anyone to come after him. He's holed up at the abandoned gas station up the hill. You mean murder him? That's not our way, even if Cobb is scum. He can bluster and threaten all he wants. Some of the others, like Sonny, will probably stand up for Ringo if he asks for help, which he hasn't. Personally, I hope he sneaks out of town one night and takes the powder gangers with him. Chain gangs, really. The NCR brought them in from California to work on the rail lines. Problem is, it turns out that giving convicts a bunch of dynamite and blasting powder isn't the best idea. It was a big escape not too long ago. Some of them stuck together so they could make trouble. That's what we're dealing with now. All right. If you were able to get Ringo out of this mess, you'd have a decent reputation around Good Springs. I'd even set you up with a discount. Of course, helping Ringo would also make the powder gangers mad, and they've got a lot of friends out there. Don't know why you'd want to do a thing like that. Yep, you'd get on their good side, but people around here wouldn't appreciate it one bit. He's a convict, just without the chains. Said his name was Cobb. Powder gangers is what they call themselves. Plenty more like him out there. I remember though I've wandered and much happiness I've found. Still I wish that I could be back there today. I know my home is waiting for me. There's always something interesting going on. But the biggest news has to be the coming dust up between the NCR and the Legion over the dam. Not much, other than they're a bunch of freeloaders who expected a few rounds on the house. I was able to get them to pay up, though. Of course, one of the great cons did knock my radio to the floor by accident, and it hasn't been working since. They were having some kind of argument about it, but the guy in the checkered coat kept shushing them. It sounded like they came in from the north through Quarry Junction. If that's the case, I can't say I blame them for not wanting to go back. That whole area is overrun with the kind of critters that just get mad if you shoot them. Merchants avoid that whole stretch of I-15 like it's radioactive, which it could be for all I know. I didn't hear exactly, but the leader was talking about the strip. Fella wants to get there and avoid the 15, he'd have to go east. Take Highway 93 up. Sure, the outside looks okay, but I think something broke on the inside. There'd be caps in it for you. I do like to hear what's going on in the world. And that Mr. New Vegas seems like such a gentleman. I know that thing as much as anyone else around here. It mostly keeps to itself, which is just fine by me. Other than rolling around once in a while, it doesn't do anything useful as far as I can tell. I don't know why it took an interest in you, but I'd be careful. It's never helped anyone before. It acts friendly enough, but I don't trust that whole cheerful cowboy act. I find it all very creepy. It was here when I took over the saloon 7 years ago. Some people have said its owner lived here, but no one knows who it was. Fine by me. Mostly traders looking to buy bighorn or meat and hides. The traders are the main reason the general store manages to stay in business. Most travelers heading south on the I-15 just push on towards Prim, unless they're in desperate need of supplies. The new California Republic's got the most power in Nevada. Money, troops, you name it. They do what they can to keep things safe in the region. But if you ask me, they're trying to do too much. They're spread too thin. I'm pretty sure the NCR wants to hold on to the dam because it's one of the few places around that can make electricity. The Legion are a bunch of savages, though. No idea why they'd want the dam. Probably plan on destroying it or something. Slavers, killers, and all other kinds of trouble. They dress up like Roman soldiers, so there's no mistaking it when you see them. The rumor is that the Legion is far larger than the NCR lets on, and that it's been due to luck that the Legion hasn't overrun the territory.
We need more people like you around.
Howdy.
I've got heartaches by the number of love that I can't win. But the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end. Heartache number three was when you called me.
That's close enough. Who are you, and what do you want with me?
You have always waited for me, and you always will be there. Sagebrush and pine, old friends of mine.
Sorry about the gun. You just caught me off guard, that's all. We got off to a bad start. Let's say we start over with a friendly game of Caravan. You know how to play?
In the shadow of the valley.
Yeah. He doesn't look very tough, though. I hear he's afraid I'll shoot him down from one of the windows when I see him. And he's right. I'll have a much bigger problem once his friends show up. There's no way I could handle all of them in a gunfight. I'm gonna lay low for as long as I can, assuming the town doesn't throw me to the wolves. I've got no chance against the gang on my own. Yeah. My caravan was on the return trip from California and heading back to the company branch in New Vegas when we got jumped. Not even a drop your weapons and hands up before the bullets started flying. We put up a good fight. There was too many of them. I took a few of the bandits down before I ran, so I figure their friends are out for revenge. Oh, sorry. I thought everybody knew already. I'm a trader with the Crimson Caravan Company. I'm, staying in town for a bit. Did you want something else? I've never stopped here until recently. You're better off asking one of the locals.
Be sure it's true when you say I love you. It's a sin to tell.
It's been in business for a very long time. It's probably the biggest trading outfit in California. There's a branch up in New Vegas, but it hasn't been doing so well. Word is that the big boss herself, Alice McLafferty, is coming in to fix things. Like I said, I'm not from Good Springs. I'm a trader with the Crimson Caravan Company. It's a two-player game, and the winner takes the whole pie. You build a caravan using the cards in your deck. The goal is to create caravan bids that beat your opponent's bids, so there's more strategy than luck involved. It's why you won't see caravan in any casino. Too slow-paced, and more importantly, no house edge. Here, take this holotape. It goes into more specifics about the rules. You'll also need a deck, so take one of my spares. So, you feel like playing a game?
Just over a whole lot of foolish words that's been spoken.
Just keep an eye out for them while you travel. I've found cards in old boxes or forgotten on shelves. You can find some for sale, too.
If you break my heart, I'll die. So be sure it's true. When you say I love you, it's a sin to tell a lie.
Heartache number one was when you left me. I never knew I could hurt this way. And heartache number two was when you came back again. You came back but never meant to stay. Yes, I've got heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. Yes, I've got heartaches by the number, a love that I can't win. But the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end.
What do you want now? What the hell for? Just farmers and ranchers out here. Not much worth stealing. Having all the food we want ain't a bad idea, actually. Getting sick of eating prison rations. First things first, though. You go settle things with Ringo and put a bullet between his eyes while I round up my crew and let them in on the plan. While you're doing that, I'll be here waiting for my friends. Join up with us once you're done.
What is it? What? No!
Evening.
I've wrangled
Hey. What do you want now? Good. We'll still need a plan before we rush the town. I don't want to embarrass myself and get beat by a bunch of townies. We ain't got much in the way of supplies. So if you could shake down the old doctor and the store owner for some stuff, we'd be in good shape. Once you're done with that stuff, or none of it, say the word and we'll make our move.
You looking to buy some supplies? What? Why the hell would I want to do that? All right. I've got some extra leather armor and spare ammo for you. Don't hurt anybody if you don't have to, all right? Take it easy now.
The dream I built for us has tumbled. Each promise broken like my heart. It's a sin, my darling, how I love you. So much in love and yet so far apart.
Welcome back. I had hoped you wouldn't need to come see me again so soon. What can I do for you?
I'm still in love with you. I'm sure you're happy.
Well, I already told you I came from a vault. After that, I was a traveling doctor for a spell. It seemed like a good idea at the time. Most folks out here ain't educated, so people with medical know-how are hard to come by. I found that I could help a lot of people with what I knew, and that was all right with me. Eventually, I went back and married my childhood sweetheart, and that was the end of my traveling days. Didn't miss it none then. Still don't. Well, ain't we all, right? That was a long time ago. I don't pay it much mind anymore. This here's Good Springs, named after the water we got here just down the road to the southeast. Good Springs Source, they call it. It's a quiet town, and that's how we like it. We don't go looking for trouble, though occasionally it sees fit to come looking for us. Well, there's a general store just up the road, run by a fella named Chet. He don't got nothing fancy, but he's got your basics covered. If you're looking to wet your whistle, just past Chet's is the Prospector Saloon. The bartender there, Trudy, knows everyone in town. Other than that, there's not much to see. Just people trying to scratch out a living. That'd be Victor. Curious fella. He's sort of odd, and I don't just mean because he's a robot. I couldn't tell you much about him. He's real friendly, don't get me wrong. You just get the sense that that ain't the whole picture. Just a feeling. He keeps to himself, mostly. You want to know more about him, you'll have to ask him yourself. He has a shack on the southern edge of town. Sure. Are you sure? What kind of injuries are we talking about? All right, that does sound bad. Here, take these. It should be enough. Good luck. I didn't see him or the men with him. You might ask around town, though. Could be someone saw which way they was headed. Your best bet would probably be Trudy, the bartender at the saloon up the road. If anyone saw anything, she'd know about it. You take care now.
Johnny Guitar, what if you go? What if you stay?
We ready to move or what?
I love you. What if you're cruel?
All right, we got all sorts of shit in here. Nice job. Better take some for yourself in case you get hit. It's about time. I saw some of the townies gathering at the saloon, so we got a militia to take down. We get rid of them, and we own this place.
Like the one they call Johnny Guitar.
It's a sin to tell a lie. Millions of
sense enough to know it's a sin to tell a lie. Whole lot of folks' heart done been broken. Just recall a whole lot of folks' word that's been spoken.
I love you. Yes, I do. So be sure it's true when you say I love you. It's a sin.
Never thought I'd ever have my own town, but thanks to you, now I do. If you want to make some caps, head on over to the correctional facility. Just tell them I sent you and you should get in without a problem. Keep a close eye on some of those bastards, though. Oh, not all powder gangers out there are friends of mine. Like the group in Prim, they'll be gunning for you no matter what, so keep that in mind. I figure we'll hang around Good Springs for a while. Maybe get some of the other gangs to join up with us. Won't kill anybody else unless we have to. Just as long as people do what we tell them, they'll be all right. Thank you.
the moon on the crest, in the shadow of the valley that I love best. You have always waited for me, and you always will be there. Sagebrush and
play it again, my Johnny. Maybe you're cold, but you're so warm inside. I was always a fool for my Johnny. Johnny Guitar, what if you go, what if you stay, I love you, what if you're cruel, you can be kind, I know.
Tried to measure my charisma on a Vitomatic vigor tester once. The machine burst into flames. I've got news for you. The influx of displaced residents to the refugee camp at Bitter Springs has caused a strain on rations there. NCR officials are asking for donations. Promotional consideration for this news program has been paid for by the Ultralux. The Ultralux. Live life in the lap of luxury.
Don't let the
more classics coming right up for you, so stay tuned.
Hey there, girly. You here to party with the Powder Gangers? This is, or was, the Big House. New California Republic Correctional Facility. Not much correcting went on here, just slave labor. One day, us prisoners decided to liberate ourselves. Killed the warden, killed the guards, took over the whole damn territory. That'll be Eddie. You can usually find him sitting in the warden's old chair up in the main building. Well, I don't know. Depends on if you can make it worth my time. 100 caps sounds right to me. Quit. That's us. We got sent here to fix the rails and make some new ones. And for that, we got to use dynamite. Of course, dynamite works pretty good against caravan guards, too. So, that's what we do. Rob and blow things up. Me? I ran with the toughest gang in the hub. You've heard of the hub, right? It's, west of here, I think, back in California. We've got the biggest, baddest fort in the wasteland. There's water and power, and if we need grub, we just go out and steal it. Yeah, whatever.
What do you want now? Well, all right, you can go on in. Can't guarantee your safety, though. Just saying. Didn't know anyone would willingly walk into this place. Not unless they were looking for trouble. What's your story? I was a sheriff, believe it or not, for a small town far to the west of here. Short version is that sometimes justice is a little slow. I helped speed it up one too many times. I'm not sorry for anything I did, but I will do the time. Fair enough trade if you ask me. I understand that Cook was behind it all. Kept my head down the whole time. Didn't want any part of it. I stuck around, figuring the NCR would show up and put things back the way they were. No sense in making myself look guilty, right? Some kind of anti-NCR rebel. Some people just don't like being pushed around and told what to do. He went north with some of the other guys. Didn't say where. Didn't say why. All I know is he's got some kind of score to settle with the NCR. I'm not quite sure the kind of greeting NCR troopers will give an escaped con like myself. Figure it's better to stay put for now. Right now, Eddie and his boys run the place. They've got the guns and the dynamite, so they call the shots. Watch yourself out there.
Hello.
I've got heartaches by the number of love.
It's about time a new customer showed up around here. I was getting sick of dealing with the same faces all the time. I was always the guy who could get things, if you know what I mean. Figured I might as well keep on doing it. I worked in a casino in New Reno. One of the pit bosses decided he didn't like me, framed me over some caps, and I ended up in here. This is where the NCR sent prisoners to reform through hard labor. I never saw much reforming around here myself. Don't have any other place to go. I'd just end up back in another prison or dead out in the wasteland. See you.
Heard there was a new face around. I'm the doctor around here. Sort of. I was an NCR medic for 6 months, so I'm not exactly a doctor. Still, it's more medical training than any of the other guys here. It also gives me an excuse to stay out of any raiding parties. The gang can't lose its only doctor now, can it? Medical supplies go for a decent amount of caps in the right markets. I figured the quartermaster wouldn't notice any missing. I was wrong. Let's see. I've been a farmhand, a bouncer, a bandit, and an NCR trooper. I don't recommend any of them. The location by the highway makes it a good spot to shake down any travelers passing through. That's why Eddie and the rest are still around. Me, I like having big walls between myself and the wasteland. One night, there was a big explosion from the other cell block. I had no idea what was going on. So I took cover in my bunk. When it was all over, the guards were dead and we were free. Most of the other prisoners scattered, but a few of us stuck around, obviously. Later.
That song ain't so very far from wrong. Oh, Lily Bell, oh, Lily Bell. Though I may have done some fooling, this is why I never fell. So I got spurs, that jingle.
What are you looking at? Why? It's because I mess up people so bad they don't know what part goes where when I'm done. Not much. Just killed a bunch of people. Maybe a couple kids, too. Whatever. Dynamite. Lots and lots of dynamite. You should have seen the body parts flying everywhere. I keep an eye on my buddy Eddie. Anybody messes with him, and I scramble them real good. Uh-huh.
Dahl said he let somebody in. So you going to give me a reason not to kill you and throw your body back outside? This is Powder Ganger territory, my territory. Most of the guys around here understand that. One, Chavez doesn't. Chavez formed his own crew and have been hitting traitors on their own. Everybody I've sent after him either got killed or weren't able to catch him. That leaves you. What do you say? Chavez is the ringleader. Without him, his crew will fall apart, and I don't give a shit about those guys. Good. Chavez and his boys were last seen south of here. If you're lucky, and he's careless, he might still be there. Why do you care? Answer, you shouldn't. I don't feel like trading life stories. It was all Cook's idea. He and his boys managed to swipe some dynamite and hide it away in their cells. The rest of us just tagged along. Cook's crew headed north while the rest of us stuck around for payback. The NCR called it a work release prison. We lucky prisoners got the privilege of fixing up the rail lines and blasting rock for new lines. They got sloppy, though. Some of us managed to hide away some dynamite, and look who's in charge now. One mean son of a bitch. Really, truly hates the NCR for some reason. He got a lot of the other guys around to his way of thinking. He and his crew went north. I heard talk about some sort of big plan to get back at the NCR, but haven't seen them since. Yeah, get out of here.
Somebody is me. I love you. And now the news. The influx of displaced residents to the refugee camp at Bitter Springs has caused a strain on rations there. NCR officials are asking for donations. One more story for you. Refugees at Bitter Springs are giving startling accounts of the legate known as Lanius, who is said to be Caesar's top field commander. One refugee told us the legate took over an underperforming squad of troops by beating its commander to death in full view of everyone. The legate then ordered a tenth of his own force be killed by the other nine-tenths. And you thought your boss was a pain. Those are our stories for this hour. This is Mr. New Vegas signing off. Just kidding. I'm not going anywhere. My love for you is too strong. Hey, New Vegas, have you ever said you love someone when it wasn't quite true? Sure you have. But you shouldn't, because it's a sin to tell a lie.
You just walked into the wrong camp, my friend. Hand over everything you've got and we might let you live.
Have been broken just because these words were spoken.
That's nothing new. Am I supposed to be impressed?
I love you. Yes, I do. I love you.
If you All right. Pickings were getting slimmer out here anyway.
Morning.
So be sure it's true when you say I love you. It's a sin to tell a lie.
Be sure it's true when you say I love you, honey. Oh, you got sense enough to know it's a sin.
Hello.
So be sure it's true when you say I love you. It's a sin to tell a lie.
gentlemen, Mr. New Vegas here. You're all so great, and we're gonna keep you listening all day. This just in. Refugees at Bitter Springs are giving startling accounts.
I've been thinking that since you've been good to us, we can be good to you. We've got plenty of spare powder and dynamite around. Say the word, and we can give you some of it every couple days. We're out at the moment. Come back later. I'm happy you cleared that up for me, but we've got another situation to worry about. There's a merchant hanging around near the prison. Something feels funny about him, and I want you to deal with him. Shake him down if he's legit, but if not, take him out. Most people already know we run this territory and are usually in a hurry to get out. Not this guy. It's like he wants us to come get him. Yeah, get out of here.
Ultra Lux. Live life in the lap of luxury. Ladies and gentlemen, this next song goes out from me to you.
Mad about the boy. I know it's stupid to be mad about the boy. But must admit the sleepless nights I've had about the boy. On a silver screen, he melts my foolish heart in every single scene.
Better be careful around these parts. I hear there's powder gangers around and dangerous for merchants like me. Guess I was a little too obvious. I'm actually a bounty hunter. I was hoping to bag some powder gangers if they tried to rob me. Yeah, was a stupid idea anyway. See you around. What? Good. Had him figured for NCR. One of the Rangers, maybe. Anyway, speaking of the NCR, I need you to take a walk down to Prim. The NCR hasn't raised hell over our breakout, and I want to find out why. They're up to something, I can feel it. I know the NCR has troops near Prim, so talk to the locals and find out if any of those troops are going to be coming our way. Yeah, get out of here.
Until the moment we met, I had no one to cling to be just everything to be my own true love. If this is a dream, let me keep on dreaming. Where have you been all my life?
Sleep, go to sleep. Just lay down your weary head. Dream, sweetly dream. Dream about tomorrow instead. Sleep, go to sleep. Whispering a lullaby tune. Dream, sweetly dream. Swinging with the man in the moon. Why don't you go? And take it slow. And don't you know all your lovely dreams will come true. So just close your eyes. Listen to a sweet lullaby. Sleep softly, sleep, and let the world go by.
Hey, where the hell do you think you're going? Prim is off limits. Some convicts from the prison up the road have taken over the town. Everyone inside is either dead or in hiding. What's more, there are two tribes of raiders causing trouble in this area as well. You'd be safer heading back up to Good Springs. We'd love to, but they don't fall under NCR jurisdiction. Even if they did, we're in no shape to protect them. We don't have the equipment to take out the convicts. And even if we did, we need some extra hands for backup. You should talk to Lieutenant Hayes. He's in a tent down the road. Just stay on the west side of the overpass if you don't want to get shot.
Who can afford passports are saying the added security is well worth the price of admission. That's the news. This is Mr. New Vegas filling in for Mr. New Vegas. Got some Dean Martin coming up, talking about the greatest feeling in the world, love. Ain't that a kick in the head? Sure is. Dino, it sure is.
How lucky can one guy be? I kissed her and she kissed me. Like the fella once said, ain't that a kick in the head? The room was completely black. I hugged her and she hugged back. Keep grinning. If this is just the beginning, my life is gonna be beautiful. I've sunshine enough to spread. It's just like the fella said. Tell me quick, ain't love a kick in the head? That a hole in the floor.
I don't suppose you came here to rescue me. I'd cross my fingers, but my hands are numb. Why, I'm Deputy Beagle, and I'm being held hostage. Can you imagine? I'd be most grateful if you would set me free. I must say it's been the low point of my career in law enforcement. The powder gangers stole into town at night and murdered my sister and her husband, the sheriff, in bed while I was sleeping in the office. I watched them for a bit, waiting for the right moment to pounce and arrest the lot of them, taking careful notes as I watched. To my dismay, they found me while I waited in the shadows and brought me here. Oh, that's just marvelous. I think I'll be making my way outside now. The air is a little close in here. Then I'll defer to your superior appraisal of character and prowess in contests of arms and see you outside.
Howdy.
Well, that was quite an adventure. We taught those convicts a thing or two, didn't we? Breaking myself out of a hostage situation, not to diminish your role in it, of course, but it was quite thrilling. Problem is, there's still no law in Prim. What are we to do the next time ruffians menace us and hold us hostage? Oh, no. I'm just a deputy, and I can't be a deputy without a sheriff. It's called chain of command. It should be someone brave like you, but more of a homebody. Someone who'll settle down and watch over us. I heard the Powder Gangers talking about someone in the prison named Myers who has some experience as a sheriff. He may be a good choice. Also, with the NCR so close by, you may be able to get them to take over the town. Not sure why they haven't helped out already. You will? That's just marvelous. I'll start thinking up questions for the interview. The sheriff that was incarcerated up at NCRCF may be a good choice. You also may be able to convince that NCR guy across the road to take the town under his wing, although martial law doesn't sound so fun.
Need to talk about something? Assuming an NCR pardon comes with the job, and it'd better. I also need to be able to do things my own way. Due process has its place. Sometimes it's just a waste of time. I'll need to know that I'm not going to end up right back in prison. All right then. Guess I'll just make a quiet exit. No need for a good...
Hello.
Oh.
shadow of the valley. I would like to settle down. Wide open space, wind on my face, a distant horizon, the moon on the crest, in the shadow of the valley that I love best. You have always waited for me, and you always will be there. Sagebrush and thank you.
in. Love's like dough that's been spent. Now there's no use of crying. Tell me, where can I go? East or west or north or new south? You let the blues move in, now I'm moving out. You let the blues move in, now I'm moving out.
Hey.
Coming from the north? Must be crazy to brave those roads. Outpost. Mojave Outpost. Watching a lot of nothing feels like a big Brahmin pen for caravans. They've been stopped for a while, waiting for the roads north to clear, or their clearance papers to go through. Looks like you've walked away, so if you need to shake the dust off, head to the barracks at the bars there. Not much, but better than nothing. Nothing I know of. But if you've come from the north, means you can travel freer than most around here. Might check the barracks. Someone might need you to hoof it somewhere. Just be careful you go up on the roof. Got a sniper watching the road. If your gear's in need of repair, HQ's also worth checking out. Talk to Major Knight. He can help. Provided you got a pen and plenty of ink. Those two represents unification. Mostly good for shade. Won't do much else when the Legion reaches us. Watch yourself.
Heard your footsteps coming up the ramp. Didn't sound like a trooper or one of the merchants. You a courier? If so, this might be your lucky day. If you don't mind walking a bit, and your eyes are good. You a courier? If so, this might be your lucky day. If you don't mind walking a bit, and your eyes are good. I think there's trouble in Nipton. No traffic from there on the roads. And while I can explain that away, smoke from the town I can't. I'm sure it's been hit. What I need to know is if they survived it. Might be powder gangers with all that smoke in the air. If there's anybody left, they'd be in the Nipton Town Hall. Go there. Check it out. Let me know what you find. Got my post. Don't think I wouldn't go too. If trouble's hit Nipton, town's got enough camping spots to rack up some easy kills. Not about to have Jackson bust my ass again, though. Even if I came back with Caesar's head, rather be sitting here than in a cell. All right. Look at you. All fired up and ready to go. Wish the others around here had that kind of attitude. Listen, I don't want you getting killed for this. So if you head there and run into trouble, I'm asking for eyes and ears, not your life. All right? Not much to tell. One of the worst posts in the NCR if you're looking to be anything more than a babysitter. Full up here, but just enough so we can't send out patrols. Gotta maintain a standing force. Jackson's orders. NCR's orders. Can't spare men for patrols or escorts, so caravans are backing up here like a Brahmin with a bottle in its ass. Typical NCR bullshit. Kimball's Kimball. Not sure which end is his ass or his head. Caravan families are causing trouble. Big circle getting tense. The usual. Look, you want gossip? Go to the bar downstairs and listen to a whole lot of nothing. Me? I gotta keep watch, then fill out the daily log. Mind yourself on the plank going down.
Thank you. New face in the outpost. Must have come from the north. So, what do you have? Work around here? Might check with Jackson in the main building, or Ghost up on the roof above, but watch out. She's kind of a bitch. Don't tell her I said that, though. Might take a bullet some night when I'm going to the latrine. Not too much. A lot of caravans going nowhere. A lot of troopers going nowhere, too. A few prospectors here and there, but they don't do more than stink up the place. Everybody's backed up here. You'd think it'd be good for business, but most of the traders are tight with the caps, even the larger caravan outfits. Take a look.
Hello.
Looking for trouble? Well, keep those eyes up and turning, or I'll set them spinning. Got no time for gawkers, or anyone looking for something I ain't selling. All right? No, I'm not all right. Drinking to forget, and it's only getting me mad instead. Whiskey always gets my temper up, now more than ever. Drinking used to cause all sorts of trouble back west. Before I punched enough people, that is. And they learned to lay low when the whiskey hit. Yeah, if you couldn't tell, I'm not from around here, and I'm not NCR. I run a caravan. Or did. Lost my caravan heading north. The driver burned to ash. And they didn't even take the cargo, they just burned that too. My guess is Legion. They're trying to cut NCR supply line, and the Mojave outpost is proof. Got us locked up tighter than a New Vegas virgin. No caravans in, out, and just try arguing with Jackson about it. Roads aren't safe, he says. No shit, you washed out old fuck up. I didn't need a Brotherhood scribe to tell me that. NCR officer, trooper, whatever, runs the place. He's over in the main building, the one without a bar. Jackson won't let me head north. It's not safe. And even though my caravan's gone, my caravan papers are keeping me here. So if you came here for work, my advice? Go find the Crimson Caravan branch south of Vegas. They can help you out. What's on your mind? You're looking at it. It's a watering hole without much to brag about. It's like a Brahmin drive gone wrong. Supposed to be a gate north, but you come here, you get caught in the pen. Better to head back home. If you don't have a gun and a will, don't matter much what you do when you reach here, except stare at that fucking monument outside. Don't even tell me you missed it coming in. It's like NCR showing its dick to all the East. If the Republic put as much effort into protecting the East as they put into those two asinine giants outside, then they'd be worth that monument. Statues of two men shaking hands covered in blood don't seem to be nothing to brag about. I'm speaking figurative. Isn't any blood on their damn hands. Of course, when Caesar comes walking through here, there'll be blood for real. And after the blood dries in the sun, he'll melt that piece of jet-induced sculpture down and reshape it into a bull, which by my reckoning is making up for a deficiency of his. But no matter what the state of his pecker, he's sure giving the West a good fucking. One's a ranger, one's an NCR trooper, supposed to represent unification of West and East, or some such shit. As far as those two iron lovebirds go, they've got more spine you'll see in a year from the NCR government. What's on? Whiskey and me are old friends. Keeps me going when times get rough. Like now. Got me into the caravan business, you know. Had to start transporting water instead of liquor, though.
If Caesar's legion decides to push west through Nipton, old Mojave outpost here will be the front line. NCR border guard duty mostly. It's our job to make sure the caravans can move safely along I-15 and Highway 95. Not the best posting or assignment, but it beats being sent east or patrolling the Colorado. Legion's pretty thick there.
It's a shame, my darling.
Hello.
Patrolling the Mojave?
Looks like we got a new visitor in the old Brahmin pen. Not many people coming here in a hurry, only passing through. And if you're passing through, you picked a bad time. Road north has gone to hell, and if I let a caravan through, they won't make it.
The dream I built for us has tumbled.
Soldiers, no. Recruits, yes. And the Mojave outpost has been ordered to have a standing force at the NCR perimeter at all times. So sending anyone out reduces the outpost's numbers and would be in direct violation of my orders from back west. Sending more troops, yes. To reinforce the outpost, no. Troops head through here on their way to McCarran, or to the front lines at Forlorn Hope. Or they're on leave, on their way to New Vegas to piss away their pay. All of them passing through. Frustrated? No, I have my orders. Signed and approved all the way up the chain from Kimball. And I understand the reasons. The outpost isn't a Legion target, yet. Not like Vegas or the Dam. But if the caravans get choked here, that's gonna bite NCR hard. Anyway, didn't mean to talk your ear off. Some days, just feel like more requisition forms and daily reports come across my desk than results. Help. Now look, I appreciate... you know what? Yes, I could use the help. You look like you can handle yourself. I need to get the caravans moving again. That means clearing a path north. There's too much crawling the asphalt up the road to allow it. Thanks, I appreciate it. Come back here when you're done. I might accidentally lose some supplies to pay you with.
Thanks for getting me that pardon. Me and the boys will take good care of Prim. Don't you worry. Watch yourself.
Heard it was you brought the law back to Prim, youngster. Hats off to you.
Johnson Nash is my name. Husband to Ruby Nash. Lived in Prim going on 8 years now, thick and thin. I'm a trader primarily, for what it's worth with things like they are. I also run the local Mojave Express outpost.
Well, I don't got any work right now, sorry to say. I'll tell you whatever I can. You have a delivery order you can show me? Oh, you're talking about one of them packages. That job had Strange written all over it, but we couldn't turn down the caps. That cowboy robot had us hire 6 couriers. Each was carrying something a little different. Pair of dice, chess piece, that kind of stuff. Last word I have in the office, it looked like payment had been received for the other 5 jobs. Guess it was just your chip that didn't make it. First deadbeat we hired to do the job canceled. Hope a storm from the divide skins him alive. Well, that's where you came in. Yeah, got this look when he saw you next down on the courier list. His expression turned right around. Asked me if your name was for real. I said, sure as lack of rain, you were still kicking. Then he turned down the job, just like that. I asked if he was sure it was good money. No, let Courier 6 carry the package. That's what he said. Like the Mojave'd sort you out or something. Then he just up and walked out. No idea. Sounds like you two had a history for him to act like that. And turn down the money, too. Hope he didn't see any trouble in that package of yours. Maybe he thought your name was bad luck. Not for me to say. Well, now that you mentioned it, a few nights back, one of the townies was out scavenging for supplies. He said he saw a fellow with a daisy suit come through with some of them great con misfits. They was talking about a chip. Well, for that, your best bet is going to be talking to Deputy Beagle. Since they came to town, he was keeping a good bit of notes on them, and he was slinking around Bison Steve when your pretty boy friend came through. He may have heard where they were going. I guess I... A Beagle had... Sure, I'll tell you what I know. I might know something, but my memory ain't what it used to be. Sometimes it needs motivating. Hold on there. With everything you already done for this town, I'd feel ungrateful as hell if I let you risk yourself for no good reason. He made me swear not to say a word to no one, but an NCR deserter passed through some days ago and traded for supplies. According to him, the NCR has decided enough's enough. And is going to send in a mess of troops to take back the prison any day now. Got a new sheriff, as you know. Meyer's a bit rougher hewn than I might have liked, but he seems like a good sort. So far, so good. I would like to settle down. Gangers, gangsters, all sounds like trouble to me. Well, I'll answer what I can. Sure do. I run the courier office out of my shop. Leastways I did before things went to hell around here. Ask away. Let's see. Been tough around here for a good while now. Worse since them thugs kidnapped our deputy. It started with the breakout from the prison up the road. First, there was just a few thugs rolling through town, but then they got organized. Now they call themselves powder gangsters or something and run around throwing dynamite and shooting people. A little while ago, a good chunk of them left whatever kind of organization they got up there to squeeze all the food and drink out of us they could.
Howdy.
Hello there. What brings you to Prim? I'm Ruby Nash. Pleased to make your acquaintance. My husband and I are Prim long-timers. He fancies himself a traitor, and I know my way around a kitchen. Thanks to you, Prim's on the way back up. With folks watching over us, I think the Raiders will keep their distance. My specialty is a rad scorpion venom casserole. It's more appetizing than it sounds. The venom has a sharp, smoky flavor, and it numbs your mouth so fierce you'll forget you ever had a tongue. It's perfectly safe, long as you don't have sores in your mouth for the venom to find your blood, 'cause that'll kill you dead. Does sound good, don't it? How many rad scorpion glands you got? Guess you'll be needing to find some, huh? Come back when you do. Bye.
Howdy, partner. Welcome to the Vicky and Vance Casino and Museum. Prim Slim at your service. Authentic cowpoke and official spoke spot of the Vicky and Vance Casino and Museum. Yeehaw! Where have you been, partner? Hiding under a rock? Vicky and Vance were this nation's fourth or maybe fifth most infamous celebrity outlaw couple ever. That's who they was. Prim Slim here can tell you the whole story, if you can spare a minute to hear the tale. Yahoo! I ain't had a chance to tell their tale in a mess of years. First things first, any boss you've heard about Vicky and Vance being copycats ain't nothing but ill-tempered slander. Fact is, they begun their crime spree 2 days before Bonnie and Clyde robbed their first bank. So who was copying who? Now true, Vicky and Vance didn't exactly cut a wide swath of murder and bank robbery across the central U.S. like Bonnie and Clyde did. It was more like a narrow swath of shoplifting, check cashing fraud, and gas pump drive-offs. But crime is crime. They drove reckless, too. Having lived by the gun, well, Vance owned one anyway, it was only fitting that the duo of desperados would die by the gun. Perhaps it was fate itself that accidentally drove them into a crossfire between police and a gang of bank robbers in Plano, Texas. Or maybe they just didn't notice until it was too late. It's been said that Vicky would have tried to cash a bad check in that bank had she lived. We'll never know for sure. All we know is that the crossfire tore the car and both occupants to pieces, and the police issued an official apology. You can put your eyes on the genuine death car just over yonder, and there's Vance's machine gun in the case next to it. Prim is a thriving resort community located in Clark County, Nevada, right along Interstate 15. Whether you can't wait till Vegas to try your luck, or want to hit one last jackpot before you leave Nevada, Prim's your place. The town's premier attraction is the world-famous Vicky and Vance Casino and Museum, so you came to the right place, partner. The Bison Steve is one of Prim's less impressive casino hotels. I'd steer clear of that place, partner, if I were you. Rumor is the dealers over there cheap, and that rickety roller coaster's liable to fall down any day because it wasn't built to code. Why, this is the Vicky and Vance Casino and Museum, Prim's premier tourist attraction and resort destination. Yeehaw!
Well, if it isn't the Lawbringer. My problem is that I'm no longer a deputy. I'm just a beagle now. Apparently, 2.5 months of law enforcement experience doesn't count for anything. The new regime is just that, all new. He's a good sheriff, but a hard man. He doesn't abide by anyone slinking by the rules. I guess there won't be any trouble, but the man's law is hard. Well, if it isn't the... Ah, yes. My memory is much clearer now that I'm free from my bondage. I was performing recon, gathering information on some of the powder gangers, when some great cons arrived with your friend in the suit. They were talking about some delivery they took from a courier. I assume that was you. They said they'd be heading through Nipton to Novak to meet a contact there.
Howdy.
What? Sounds like they're already here. There's no way I'm letting them take me alive. There's no reason for you to stick around and help us, but feel free to kill a few of the bastards on your way out.
So be sure it's true when you say I love you. It's a sin to tell a lie.
Be sure it's true when you say I love you, honey. 'Cause you got sense enough to know it's a sin. A lot of
say I love you.
Hello.
Appreciate the help. Wish I had more work for you, but nothing else on the radar at the moment. No, I mentioned you might accidentally get supplied, and I meant it. Not allowed to contract mercenaries at the outpost. Still, a requisition form or two can get lost, and they're not gonna come check. So here you go, just between us.
Hello there. It's good to see a friendly face. I almost took you for a raider, I did. Name's Malcolm. Malcolm Holmes. Don't suppose you'd care to trade. I'm missing a few essentials and... screw this. Lying just ain't in my nature. I'll tell it to you straight. I've been following you for a good bit now. It started off innocently enough. I was traveling, as I often do, and happened to observe you picking up one of those blue star caps. You didn't show any reaction to it. So, I figured you didn't know what you'd gotten your hands on. There's an old wasteland legend that says somewhere out there is a fabulous treasure from before the war. Those caps with the blue star on them, the tale goes, are the key to that treasure. They're called Sunset Sarsaparilla Stars. All over the place. The easiest place to find them is unopened bottles of Sunset Sarsaparilla. You'd think they'd all have been picked clean by now. But somehow, new bottles keep appearing in the machines. Some say it's old Festus that does it, hoping someone will finally collect enough caps to earn the treasure. Other than bottles, you'll just have to scavenge. You can find caps in the unlikeliest of places, and Blue Star caps are no exception. It's said that the treasure is guarded by a man named Festus, and he's the one who asked for the Blue Star caps. It's also said he's been around since the war, standing a lonely vigil, waiting for someone to come and take the treasure off his hands. That'll make him pretty damn old, but I've met a few people in my travels who claim they actually met him, and they weren't the lying type either. Nah, I gave it up years ago. Too dangerous. And even if I did still collect them, I'd tell you the same. There's people out there so mad with the idea of treasure that they'll attack strangers just on the suspicion that they have some of those caps. No one knows. Money, weapons, water. It is, or maybe was, something of value, and that's enough to get people motivated. No problem. If you do end up trying to collect more stars, watch out for a man named Alan Marks. He's killed several people for their stars already.
My darling, how I love you, because I know our love can never be. It's a sin to keep this memory of you when silence proves that you've forgotten me. The dream I built for us has tumbled, each promise broken like my heart. It's a sin, my darling, how I love you, so much in love and yet so far apart.
You like that?
It's a sin to hide behind this heartache, to make me believe that I found someone new. It's a sin to say that I miss you when I know that it's a sin.
Play the guitar, play it again, my Johnny. Maybe you're cold, but you're so warm inside. I was always a fool for my Johnny.
Did you see that? That crazy bitch just attacked me out of nowhere.
Play it again.
No, none at all. We've been traveling together since I picked her up a few days ago. And she's been friendly this whole time. We'd actually been flirting a little when she suddenly pulled a gun out and began yelling at me to hand my caps over. Now that I think of it, though, she laughed when I threw her my money. I think what she really wanted was my Lucky Charm necklace. Yeah, every once in a while you can find a cap with a blue star on it. They're pretty rare, so I started collecting them. Once I had enough, I made a necklace out of them, since I thought they were lucky. Really? I had no idea. And here I've been carrying them all this time, never knowing how dangerous they were. What do you think I should do with them? Bury them or something? They're all yours. I sincerely hope they work better for you than they did for me.
Sure, but not no more. Powder Gang is small time, man. I'm a winner. I won the motherfucking lottery.
Bye.
Damn it! I was nodding off until you barged in here, and I don't hurt when I sleep. Wait, you're that courier. Hey, know what boxcars needs, friend? Some fucking pain relief. I don't know. I just love it here. What the fuck do you think, asshole? Prize for second place was I got to live, but they beat my fucking legs with hammers. I'm fucking crippled, get it? Bullshit. You're holding. You just want it all for yourself. Luck, that's how. I'm just that fucking lucky. You're looking at the second place winner of the Nipton lottery. That asshole Swanick took first place, so him they let walk. It ain't like we came to Nipton to play it. Me and my crew had it worked out to kidnap some NCR troopers who come to town to get laid. Had it all worked out with the scumbag mayor. We were going to ransom them off, keep their weapons for ourselves, a nice score. We get in position, and next thing we know, we're surrounded by those fucking Legion freaks. They dragged us and everybody else into the center of town. And that asshole with a dog on his head, he starts talking about how we're bad people. He said we needed to be punished for what we did. Not all of us, but some of us. And then he gives everyone a fucking lottery ticket. What do you think? He started drawing tickets, and that's how people got punished. First up was the lucky losers. They got decapitated. Guess that's lucky, because it's pretty quick. Then came the crucifixions. God damn, but those went on and on and on. Third place runners-up got enslaved. I got the fuck beat out of my legs, and the winner, they let go free. Him? When his ticket came up, they burned him alive on a pile of tires. Yeah. A bunch of those Legion fucks dragged them off right away. They were headed east, if you're feeling heroic. Don't act like you'd be doing me a favor. I don't give a fuck. The Legion happened. What the fuck's it look like? Like what? Later.
Don't worry. I won't have you lashed to a cross like the rest of these degenerates. It's useful that you happen by. I want you to witness the fate of the town of Nipton, to memorize every detail. And then, when you move on, I want you to teach everyone you meet the lesson that Kaisar's Legion taught here, especially any NCR troops you run across. Where to begin? That they are weak and we are strong? This much was known already. But the depths of their moral sickness, their disillusion, Nipton serves as the perfect object lesson. Nipton was a wicked place, debased and corrupt. It served all comers, so long as they paid. Profligate troops, powder gangers, men of the Legion, such as myself. The people here didn't care. It was a town of whores. For a pittance, the town agreed to lead those it had sheltered into a trap. Only when I sprang it did they realize they were caught inside it too. Yes, and herded them to the center of town. I told them their sins, the foremost being disloyalty. I told them that when legionaries are disloyal, some are punished, the others made to watch. And I announced the lottery. Each clutched his ticket, hoping it would set him free. Each did nothing, even when loved ones were dragged away to be killed. Ha! Innocent. Hardly. Cowardly, though. They outnumbered us, yet not once did they try to resist. They stood and watched as their fellows were butchered, crucified, and burned. One by one, they stood and hoped their turn would not come. Each cared only for himself. As are all crimes, if you feel strongly about it, attack us, and soon you won't feel a thing.
sin, my darling, how I love you. Because I know our love will never be. It's a sin to keep this memory of you. When silence proves that you've forgotten me. The dream I built for us has tumbled. Each promise broken like my heart. It's a sin, my darling, how I love you. So much in love and yet so far apart.
You check out the Nipton Town Hall yet? Smoke trail's not getting any shorter. Legion this far west? You're fucking kidding me. That's not outside the border. They're moving in, and fast. Nipton wasn't the most friendly town, but... All right, thanks for checking on that. Wish it set my mind at ease. Now I'm more on edge than ever. In Nipton? Hell no. Town was a shithole, asking to be burned. Just not by Legion. Nobody deserves that. Well, thanks for hoofing it there and back, even if it was bad news. Wish we could spare the troops to go hunting, but orders are to stay put. Fucking Mojave's going to hell, and all I can do is sit here and watch.
back, but never meant to stay. Yes, I've got heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. Yes, I've got heartaches by the number, a love that I can't win. But the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end.
Hey there.